This is my intro to programming. I'm Leland Broom from Sterling High School. The language I used for this is Python. I've never coded in Python, so I thought it'd be fun to learn a new language, and it was pretty simple to do something for a GPA calculator. I used tkinter because it's the only pre-installed GPU library or GUI library for Python, and I didn't really want to use pip or anything to install something else to use, and it was still simple, it was easy to use and learn. The user interface was mouse interaction only, so you just had to use your mouse to click on all of these buttons. At the bottom, there's a new button, and that would reset all of the data for these inputs, and then it would get it ready to calculate a new GPA. There's an undo button right here, and that's going to undo the credits in the class that you just added, and then there's these labels, and then you have your grade evaluation here. So in this example, 8 classes with 28 credits, and then your GPA is 3.5. These are the variables that I used, which I can get into here. The variables, you have to set Roo as tkinter, not exactly sure why. The title, and then you have all these variables like this string var and int var. These aren't usual Python syntax, but it's tkinter. It just you have to use these so you can store a variable that a GUI button can use. You have the letter and all these, the literal points, and then you have your arrays. This is for like a score for the credit or for the classes. You have your credits and then your total list, and all of these are just used to calculate your GPA. Back here, you have your UI, which is organized at the bottom here. Once you get to here, it's your top frame, and then all of these are organized. You have top frame, and then you make everything that you want to be in the top frame, and then you basically just do that. Like this is a frame, a GPA grade frame, which I'm pretty sure is for this, everything like this middle section under the course grade. And then you have a button for add class, and then that's put in the GPA grade frame. So it's just, you make buttons, you put them in the frame, and then it organizes them the way you'd want them to be. I have data storage for this, and I can actually just show you. If I run the program real quick, I have it right here. I can just put in random things. If I put in 5 classes and I try and calculate it, it'll warn me. I must have 8 classes because that's how many we have in Sterling. So now I have 8 classes, 26 credits. Here is the previous one, the last one that I calculated for. And my GPA classes and credits. This is where it writes the GPA data. It'll open up the file that's pre-created, and it sets it to W for write. It will overwrite everything that's put in here. And then it writes the credits, and then the sum of the score list. So there. And then a break, classes, break your GPA, and then it'll just use the GPA variable to write there. But now if I press calculate GPA, you'll see it update real time. So now 26 credits, 8 classes, 3.25 GPA, and then it evaluated, it said it had a B, and it was a very good GPA. And then that's it for the GPA calculator. Thank you.